I got a key. Look, take it if you need it.
What did you
see those marks? They line up perfectly with your Denver tool.
Mine or anybody else's. Even if it was a Denver tool, no firefighter did that. If I really wanted to bring that door down, I'd pry the hinges off. The last thing I'd do is hack at it like a maniac.
The fire was set by someone with the knowledge to burn that building to the ground.
I don't care what you say. I would never start a fire.
Oh, let's see if he's lying. Let's see if I've got any evidence first.
Drywall at the spa was ventilated with a Denver tool.
Well, it wasn't my Denver tool. Anybody can buy one on the internet. Even Portia had one.
Why did Portia have a Denver tool?
She took mine. She wanted it for protection. Said it creeped her out to be alone in that place all day.
By that place, do you mean the spa?
Yeah, she had hers at the spa.
Know something? You're right. There are a lot of other Denver tools floating around out there. But in this case, I really only think there's one I need to worry about. And it belongs to you.
Yeah!
I followed Portia to the spa. She was nice and relaxed with a mud bath. You torched the place. Then you went back to her apartment to get your things. And a few of her things too. And then you tried to disappear. But you figured, hey, if it looks like a break-in, then no one will suspect the boyfriend who's already got a key to the place. And that might have worked for you, too. But you forgot to light a fire under yourself. You were still standing right there when we rolled up.
Captain, I respect the police. I really do. I know what it's like to go out there every day and put it all on the line. And I know you're just doing your job. But if you can look me straight in the eye and really hear what I'm saying to you, and yet still believe that I could do this to Portia, then I feel very... very sorry for you, because you're not qualified to carry that bag.
That animation.
Are you really gonna arrest me, or what?
No, we're not going to arrest you, Brian. But we'd appreciate if you could hold tight here for a while.
All right, I will. For now, like I said, I'm happy to answer your questions, but no more finger pointing, or I'm done.
We understand. Thank you. You said that Portia spent hours alone at the spa. How often did she do that?
Just about every day. You know, there were times I started to believe that place might be some sort of front.
A front?
Yeah, you know, for money laundering. Portia was convinced, and she was keeping her own records. She told me that place wasn't making a dime.
Did anyone else know Portia was keeping financial records?
I think she might have mentioned it to a boss, which seemed like the wrong guy to talk to about it, but she trusted him. At least she did. But after she talked to him, she got all paranoid. Ended up hiding all the papers in the broiler drawer. I thought she was just high. Hey, you guys looking at him for this?
Thanks for sticking around.
No problem. I'll be waiting.
Right. I thought, because we're still not done with his shop, we still need to search it. If we can search it.
Sorry, I was shaving. Cut myself. What can I do for you?
Portia Weissman owned a firefighting tool. She kept it at the spa for security. Have you seen it?
No. She had some kind of weapon at the spa? That's totally against company policy.
Oh, bye. We're going now.
Looking forward to it.
Thing that he threw, I want it. Out on the street. Public property.
Good catch. That should contain a workable sample of his DNA.
There we go.
DNA ready for processing.
Right. I am so ready. It's so hard to move around. Okay. Oh, I used to like these.
Was in Portia Weissman's apartment, even though he told us he'd never been there.
Ha!
How's the arson case?
Oh, not you.
Is your decorated fireman still a prime suspect?
I'm not so sure now. He's got an answer for everything. And what I thought was the best evidence we had against him, his firefighting tool, well, it doesn't actually provide us with anything conclusive.
It's not even got his prints on it.
Lied to us about never visiting the victim's apartment.
All right. Well, talk to Brass. See if he can help you take a closer look at this, Mr. Baja.
All right. You're down here already. I was just going to call you. This is Special Agent Gene Huntby of the FBI.
Hello.
It seems your case may be crossing into his jurisdiction. Agent Huntby, why don't I let you explain the situation to them?
Thank you, Captain Brass. It's my understanding your prime suspect in the arson fire at the Super La Spa is Pedro Baja. Is my information correct?
We're looking at him for the arson and a homicide. A young woman by the name of Portia Weissman died in the fire.
Is that right? Well, let me explain why I'm here. Are you familiar with Lorena de la Colmena? Unfortunately, as a member of law enforcement, you should be. In Spanish, it means the Queen of the Hive, and it's the alias for a woman named Beatriz Salazar. Now the most dangerous drug lord in Mexico. We believe Pedro Baja was in her employ.
Okay. So is this the part where you tell us to back off Mr. Baja and let you do your job?
No, Ms. Seidel, not at all. I want you to get your man. I want you to get him so bad he'll have no choice but to cut a deal. You see, in the entire universe of La Reina de la Colmena's drug trafficking operation, Baja's just a satellite. A small-time money launderer through those little shops of his. But for some reason, we have him on wiretaps in direct communication with Salazar. The taps themselves are useless because Baja and Salazar communicate in code, referring to things like family, weather, whatever. But why she's talking to him directly instead of through an intermediary, I have no idea. But it's that direct connection that means if we can bring down Baja, then we have our best shot yet at taking down the Queen of the Hive herself.
Agent Huntby has requested the opportunity to keep tabs on us for a while. And run this one as a joint jurisdiction.
You do your thing, I'll do mine.
Fair enough. Right, I want a warrant. Now. From you, specifically. Yes, warrant to search! Oh, piss. That.
There when Baja said he'd never been in Portia Weissman's apartment. His DNA in that apartment will get you your warrant.
Yes.
Looks like he's not here. Guess we'll have to execute the warrant without him.
Kick the door in!
Score one for the lockpick gun. Always cleaner than breaking out the battering ram.
Aww. Yeah, but less fun. What's the point in owning a battering ram if you don't get to use it? Alright, let's go in here. We'll bang. Is that on the floor? Ugh. A thing?
It looks like an empty financial or legal portfolio. With the spa's logo on it, those records we found in the Vic's oven are just the kind you'd keep in a binder like this.
Ooh, hard drive.
Look at that. The hard disk isn't screwed in. It might just be new, but the Vic's PC was missing a hard drive. We can figure it out back at the lab.
Ooh. Hey.
Vegan blueberry muffins. They look almost edible and flammable.
As if you just keep that lying around. Oh, what's that?
These tax forms claim that Superla Spa was highly profitable.
This isn't looking very good, Mr. Barha. Ooh, shoes! Give.
You can tell a lot about a person from the kind of shoes they wear. You can tell a lot more if you forensically examine their shoes.
Was that your attempt at a joke? It was awful.
Just pick that up.
Yes, she can.
Can't just pick that up.
Yes, she can. For God's sake. I just, well, what was the point? That's it there. So let me just.
You can't just pick that up.
Yes, she can. Oh, there you go.
Looks like some kind of dried mud.
Am I still not done with the shoes? I might have to take him back to the lab. Is there something in here? Oh, what's that? Back out. Wait, no, go back in. And turn. Boom!
That looks just like the tool we got from Reed.
There's a thing on it though. There's some stuff on the blade. Is that a blade? There's some stuff. Just turn it. That stuff that I can collect? I guess not. Can I get something else? Oh! Fingerprints! Yeah.
That could tell us who handled this tool.
I bet it was him. Or it might not have been. I don't know. I can't remember. It's not looking good though. We got enough? Still more? Okay. Is there anything else in here that... There was an arrow around here. I'm sure there was. I guess not. Oh. Ugh. It's so difficult to move around. there anything else down here that I need? I don't think so. Oh, God. I'm not convinced that you've searched it enough. You need to search it some more. Was responsible for the fire at the spa. Chances are we'll find something that's to support that at the bar. What do you think I'm doing here? What do you think I'm doing here? There's got to be something else in here. Oh, what's that? Aha! Gotcha!
I wonder why they need so much acetone. Place is a little too masculine for manicures.
You done? Oh God, really? More? There's more to find? Any fingerprints on it? I guess not. Well, this has got to be something else then. But what is it? What is there? Oh! Oh, I forgot! Give!
Made for cutting pipes, and we have a severed gas line to account for.
Ha 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 ha! That's gotta be it. Really? There's more? What else is in here? Oh, what's that up there? That's nothing. Can I go along here? Maybe. I thought that was a thing. Guess not. Ugh. That's got to be enough to nail him, surely. Stop it. Are you going to help at all? It wouldn't be totally conclusive to find the source of the muffin within Lutton. I already found that. Give me a useful tip. How have we not found everything? Couch, maybe? Let's go back in here. What's that on top of his computer? No, I can't see. Ugh. Bottle, maybe? What's the bottle? Won't let me go that far. What's all that on the floor? What are we nailing for that? Having stuff.